Welcome to Engineer on Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about the basics of strings and how to access string elements using indexing and slicing. In Python, a string is a sequence of characters enclosed within a pair of double or single quotation marks. This S is a string. It contains two words, hello, world, and a space. They are enclosed with the double quotation marks. We can print the string using the print function. We can check the data type of variable s. It's a string. A pair of quotation marks, double or single, with nothing inside is an empty string, like this one. In this statement, we will show the user a message, what's your name? The user's input, which is a string, will be given to this variable name. For example, the user's input is Jack Sparrow. Now we can say hi to this user by joining two strings together. The first string is hi and the second is a name. They are separated by a comma in the print function. Note that curved quotation marks won't work, no matter single or double. Like this print hello world or this one. Python will show you there is an invalid character. We can use quotation marks inside quotation marks. For example, he said, you look young. We have single quotation marks inside double quotation marks. Or this one, double quotation marks inside single quotation marks. They are both acceptable because there is no confusion about the meaning. We can also use double inside double and single inside single. But because it may cause confusion, we have to use a backslash to escape an inner quotation mark. Like this or this. Another way is to use a triple quoted string. In this example, there are three double quotation marks at the beginning and three at the end. So everything in between will be printed verbatim. Here, there are three single quotation marks at the beginning and three at the end. It also works well. String indexing and slicing are two very important concepts. We will talk about indexing first. We can use indexing to access individual characters in a string. If we count from left to right, string indexes start with 0 and increase. If we go from right to left, they start with negative 1 and decrease. Let's use a string variable name as an example. Name contains a string, Jack Sparrow. This image illustrates the indexing concept very clearly. In this statement, name is followed by a pair of brackets and a zero inside the brackets. It means we are accessing the zeroth element of this string. The zeroth element is just a letter J. This statement prints three letters in the string. The zeroth letter, which is J, the third letter, which is K, and the negative 11th letter, which is A. Now let's talk about slicing. We can use slicing to access a consecutive sequence of characters or a substring in a string. This is the syntax. The string's name followed by a pair of brackets. Inside the brackets, we have a start position and an end position. Both start and end must be an integer number. What it does is that it produces a substring beginning at start and runs up to but does not include end. Let's still use Jack Sparrow as an example. This statement accesses a substring of name from the fifth character, which is S, to the 100th character, which is greater than the highest index, 11. Then we ignore the 9 existing characters and only go up to 11. The output is Sparrow. This statement doesn't define a starting point, so it accesses the substring from 0 to 5, but not including 5. So the output is Jack Space. This statement doesn't define an end, so it accesses the substring from 5 to the very end of the string. This one will access a substring from negative 9 to negative 6, but not including negative 6. So the output is K space S. This one will access a substring from negative 3 to the very end. so the output is raw. This one will access a substring from the very start to negative 6, but not including negative 6. The output is jack space s. This one uses a mix of both positive and negative indexes. It accesses a substring from positive 2 to negative 6, ck space s. This one from 9 to 5, not including 5. Because the start and end are both positive numbers, and the end is less than the start, we cannot go backwards. The result is an empty string. The last one, from 3 to 3, but not including 3, this is also an empty string. Okay, I just talked about the basics of strings, string indexing, and string slicing in this video. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.